Hello friends, in this video we are going to look at how to use Cricketscreener tool to analyze ball by ball data from various matches. So here I will take two examples of two different queries, one is related to batting and one is related to bowling, and we will see how one can query this, so how one can use this tool. So the first query is, I want to find out how many times Dhoni has finished a match with a six. So if you hear the query again, how many times Dhoni has finished a match with a six. So if you see here, the batsman is Dhoni. So you should search Dhoni in this. So you should always search here with the second name, since the, I mean, from where I have got the data is stored with the second name there. So MS Dhoni against all the bowlers. Runs, all the runs, extras, all these extras, and then we need to include last ball, right? So we need to include last ball or evening, yes. Then we also include it, he has finished with a six, so runs will be six. Now we can you can also use the format ODI T20 test, but I'm including all the formats here, and I will just press submit now. So it will take a bit of time, so it needs to query the whole database. And if you see, you have got 17 results. So this is 17 times he has finished with a 6 in ODI T20 and test, and this data is from 2005 onwards. So if you see, first one is 2007, and you can also get the link here. So link will, if you click on the link, so you will just get the, if you open the first link, this will be the related to the match in which he hit the 6. Also, you get a summary of how many balls are there, total runs, 4, 6s, wickets here. And in the results, you see, you get all the data, format, team, everything, inning, batsman, non-striker, bowler, which was the over number. And this is for both the innings, first and second inning. You can separately query for 1 and 2 separately also if you want. Let's go to the Cricketscreener again. So if you needed to only query for the second inning, what you can do is, in the inning section, you can just click here to, and then you can query. Let's go to the another query, second example that's related to the bowling. How many times Zahir Khan has dismissed Graham Smith? So if you, now we are dealing with bowler, and we will look at all the three formats from, I mean, 2005, 2019, and all the opposition. So here the opposition is, if you see India, and team is Indian, opposition is South Africa, but we can just leave them blank because I mean the only drawback will be that in the, I mean the MySQL table it will query all this, but we don't need to worry about that. But we can optimize this by including team also, India and South Africa here if you want. So this is a batsman. So the batsman here is Smith. So always use the second name while searching. Now you see there are many Smith, but if you know Graham Smith, that is G Smith, right? So if you go down, you see two, I mean G Smith, GC Smith, GP Smith, and the title is GC Smith because if you see the full name of Graham Smith on the Wikipedia, it is GC Smith. GC Smith, the bowler here is Zahir Khan. So you can type Khan. Again, there will be many, I mean, you can go to Jad Khan. That should be at the bottom, or you can just do a query like Jad Khan. So yeah, this I mean, finding the bowlers and the players is a bit tough in this because the names are such. Now you need to, did wicket fall, you tick yes. I mean, there was a wicket when these two faced. Then just click submit. It will take a bit of time again, and you will get all the instances from 2005 onwards. So in the six series, if you see, he dismissed him four times. Again, 11, 10, 11, he dismissed many times. So you can get everything, like how he was dismissed, LBW, then who was the fielder involved, and you can get the link of the matches also. So that's two examples, batsman and bowler. You can also try it by yourself, like finding whatever query, so how, whichever query you want to run, and see if you're getting the results. And also you could suggest what we can improve in this, what I can improve in this. Also, I've written a blog post related to this. you can find the blog post link in the video description, and that will actually that will be very helpful in knowing like how this is working. Thank you.